warm welcome to all the viewers to this briefing session on the upcoming new fund offer from Aditya Birla Sun Life Mutual Fund. And the fund that we are here to talk about today is ABSL Business Cycle Fund. Today I'm joined by the fund manager for this fund, Mr. Vineet Malu, who will take us through with much more detail on this fund, our investment approach, positioning and strategy. Welcome, Vineet.
Thank you.
So we need to elaborate a bit more on what is business cycle, what is the concept of business cycle, and how would investors benefit from it?
So business cycle is something where economic activity repeats itself, or the pattern of economic activity repeats itself in a specific sequence. However, unlike specific fixed time interval based cycle, like for example planetary motions, etc., this is not at all fixed in terms of either time interval or in terms of its amplitude. One good analogy is that of seasons, where seasons differ in their lengths as well as their severity. In terms of business cycles, one can think about that variability multiplied by at least 5 times. And because of that variability, there are opportunities by investing in specific sectors which benefit from different phases of the business cycles. So that's what our strategy is based on. Take advantage of different phases of the business cycles.
So Vineet, how would you ascertain these different phases of business cycles?
So how we look at business cycle is what the economy is doing, right? If the economy is in an expansion phase, which means the economic growth or GDP growth is actually moving up. And there are indicators which suggest that that is happening. So we can track industrial production, which we can track what is the movement of goods and goods which is happening through transportation related indicators. We can track what is the credit growth, etc. So there are a whole host of indicators which suggest, you know, what the economy is doing. When that growth rate actually stabilizes at a high level, that's when the economy peaks. And typically it is associated by signs of overheated environment in the economy. Prices are rising rapidly, employment is doing extremely well, credit growth is quite high. These are some of the signs of a typical overheated level of economy. And when growth starts actually coming down, we call it a contraction phase, where, you know, demand kind of slows down, demand related indicators start showing a bit of weakness. And eventually it leads us into a slump phase where all hell is broken loose. Employment is declining, industrial production is declining, bad assets are rising for banking sector, etc., etc., right? So there are different economic indicators which tells us which phase of the economy we are in.
So Vineet, as I understand, as the different business cycles change, there are of course, different sectors do well. That's because different activities basically in phases of expansion, there are certain sectors do well which are more related to manufacturing or buying luxury goods, discretionary consumption goes up. As compared to that, in phases of contraction or slowdown, it's only essential item, everyday use item, FMCG or medicines, say something like pharma, healthcare will do well. So while you would be allocating to these sectors, how will your choice of sectors happen? And how would you, would there be any disproportionate amount of focus that you will put on a certain set of sectors at one point in time?
What we're trying to do in this strategy is understand from extremely top-down level where the economy is, right? So there are 3 levels of questions we ask. One is where the economy is in its business cycle. Is it moving away from its mean and equilibrium level, right? Or is it likely to mean revert? And the third question is, if it mean reverts, where are the opportunities, right? Typically what we see is when economy mean reverts from a slump towards peak phase through the expansion, the sectors which are geared to the economy cycle, where the relationship is positive, their earnings benefit as the economic activity moves up, as demand increases, they tend to do well, right? Similarly, on the other side, where the economy travels the journey from peak towards the slump through the contraction phase, the sectors which don't have anything to do with the cycles that are insulated from that downturn in the economic cycle, right? So our idea is, understand which phase of the economic cycle we are in. Based on that, decide whether we want to adopt a defensive stance in the portfolio or a non-defensive stance or aggressive stance within the portfolio, right? And as a group, we've seen that these two groups, tend to do pretty well in their own specific phases of the cycle. From a slump towards the peak through expansion, non-defensives do well. From peak to slump through the contraction, defensives do well. So our idea is, you know, calibrate the stance of the portfolio based on these two groups of, you know, sectors.
So Vineet, as we speak, all the data points suggest that, you know, economic activity is improving, markets are doing well. It seems that the economy is in an expansion phase. So what would be your portfolio allocation approach at this point in time? And as the cycle was to turn, how would you, you know, ideally tweak or review your portfolio?
So Medha, as you said, we are in expansion phase, and I agree with that. And based on that, our portfolio stance is, you know, be overweight on non-defensives. However, I would like to qualify that stance by saying that, you know, we are kind of moderately, we would like to be moderately overweight on the non-defensive as of now versus, let's say, maybe 6 months ago, 12 months ago, where the pace of expansion was much more rapid. And the only reason is we've traveled some distance in this journey. Now, if we look at within this bucket of non-defensive, there are sectors that we clearly like, where we believe that the journey to travel from their own business cycle, from their own, let's say, slump towards their own peak is much, much longer. For instance, we like banking and financial services sector, where we believe, you know, credit growth has only just started to pick up, and there's a longer journey for this sector, sector to travel, and investors can benefit from that, being overweight there. Then there are domestic cyclicals that we like, where we believe domestic demand is only you know, starting to pick up now after you know, two lockdowns related to the two specific large COVID waves in India. So that's where a bit of a journey still left to be traveled, where we believe investors can benefit. There are certain other sectors like metals we want to be only marginally overweight because they've already traveled quite a bit of the journey based on the economic recovery in the global marketplace or the global economy. Right, so we calibrate our stance on each individual sector depending on where it is in its own business cycle, and that's how, you know, we want to be positioned in the portfolio.
So I think we need the concept of the fund is quite well understood, but a common question that our viewers would have is, considering markets are at the levels that they are, is it a good time to be in a fund like this? While, of course, I do understand that this is a fund where an investor has to look at at least a five-year sort of an investment horizon. But still, is it a good time to be in a fund like this?
So, Medha, one thing I firmly believe is an absolute level of market is never an indicator of whether one should invest in equity markets or any fund or not. Right? If I were to ask you 5 years ago, you know, what was the all-time high of the market, you know, I think very few people would remember, and if I were to go back 10 years, then even lesser number of people would remember. I don't know what it was, you know, 5 years ago. But the whole point is that in this fund, we take care of the investor's journey from one sector to another based on its own cycle. We take care of the portfolio stance from defensive to non-defensive and back to defensive based on the overall economic cycle, etc. Right? So there's a solution embedded in it. Investor doesn't have to worry about when to buy, when to exit, etc. Right? Investor doesn't have to worry about timing the markets, doesn't have to worry about timing the sectors. What we do is we rely on the mean reversion and, you know, have built in the solution in the fund. That's why I would say the absolute level of the market is not an input into deciding when to invest in this kind of fund.
A final question, Vineet, how is this fund different from other diversified equity funds or maybe even thematic funds too?
So this fund is different in the sense that a typical diversified category fund has all the flexibility to go underweight or overweight any sectors regardless of the overall stance you know, that is warranted by the economic cycle. For instance, they could be overweight in pharma or IT, and they could be overweight on metals and infrastructure and banking, etc. Right? So depending on the fund manager's view and depending on their own analysis, what it suggests. Our approach is take a more broader stance first, decide what is going to be our approach, whether we are going to play defensively or whether we are going to be offensively positioned in the market, right? And then decide which are the sectors more attuned to that, right? In terms of the economic cycles. Are there sectors which are being constrained by some specific factors? And if so, then we would want to be less exposed to those sectors and be more tilted towards some other sectors. That's our stances. So we have a clear-cut defined top-down approach. We also have, you know, much sharper activates on these sectors where we take a positive stance on. That's how it differs from a typical diversified category fund. In terms of thematic, they have to permanently focus on one theme only. The room to play for them is very limited within that theme, right? We have a much wider canvas available to us, but our degrees of freedom are much lesser than a diversified funds, but much larger than a thematic fund. So we are, I would say, you know, with this strategy placed in kind of a sweet spot, you know, where a bit of a overarching framework provides us some stability, and then, you know, reasonable degrees of freedom allows us to maneuver.
Thank you, Vineet, for your valuable insights. So two key takeaways I have from our discussion today. One is that we have a platform out here through this fund to participate in the various sectors of the market without having to worry about when to entry and when to exit out of the sector, because the fund is going to do that job of smoothly maneuvering in the right set of sectors based on a phase of business cycle. And the second great advantage that comes from this fund is that no matter what is the allocation in the underlying index of a particular sector, some sectors have very small allocation. But for this fund, if the cycle is favorable, if the tide is favorable for that particular sector, there is merit to have a significant overweight position too. So that is another benefit that the investors can have through a fund like this. They can be rest assured about the need to entry and exit different sector funds. All of that is coming in a single platform. So thank you very much, viewers, for your invaluable listening time, and have a great day ahead.
Mutual fund investments are subject to market risks. Read all scheme-related documents carefully.